A servant of God, I am Robert Simon. Beloved in Christ, loving greetings. Faith, we are continuing on the same topic, faith. Hebrews chapter 11 verse 6 reads, "But without faith it is impossible to please him, for he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him." In my last talk, I said we would consider the second part of Hebrews 11:6 in this talk. Hebrews 11:6 says, "Without faith, it is impossible to gratify God or to make God happy and satisfied. For he that cometh to God or draweth to God must believe that he is, must believe that God is." It is not just believing that God is in existence. It is much, much more than that. I last night before my bedtime was reading a book written by the great man of God in our times, A.W. Tozer, with the title, "The Dangers of a Shallow Faith." There I could find, to my great blessed surprise, his definition and explanation in a no lackluster style of the most powerful words, "God is." This my rendezvous with a man of God is not my own volition, but certainly divine providence. God knew I was too small to handle this great and noble topic, so A.W. Tozer. Praise God. Let me read to you what A.W. Tozer says. "Men are not willing to let God be what he says he is. They attempt to change, correct, alter, and apologize for God in an attempt to make him be other than what he is. God is, and we had better accept him as he is. We had better want him to be what he is and conform ourselves to what he is. No lasting structure can be built on a bad foundation. A faulty foundation will cause it to sink, collapse, lean, and fall over, bringing the structure down in time." So A.W. Tozer says, "Of all foundations, God is the most important because God is God. It would be a great and bitter error for a man or woman to go on for a lifetime believing certain things about God only to learn they were not true. To think they were talking to the God of heaven and earth and find they were talking to a God fashioned out of their own imagination. It would be a tragic, certainly to the human spirit, to pray and preach a lifetime about a God who was not the true God, but composite of ideas drawn from philosophy and psychology and other religions and superstitions. God is what he is, and we had better learn what God is and then conform our teachings to that truth. If we take away any of the attributes of God, we weaken our concept of God." I continue with A.W. Tozer. "So we better make the study of his word the business of our lives to find out what he is, and then we must conform our views to his." Beautiful words of A.W. Tozer. Many a time, we all make a big and terrible mistake akin to how those proverbial 8 blind men were trying to define an elephant. As Jet Truth states, "A rose is a rose is a rose. God is God is." Hallelujah. In my next talk with you, I shall try to explain the same thing in my words. I'm sure I will not be making the mistake of painting the lilies. Keep in your prayers. Till then, God bless you. God be with you. I am yours, Robert Simon.